Yo, what's up, guys? So here in the garage, we got my Lowrider ST here. And so just gonna walk through the mods that I've thrown on it. I've listed it all in the description, all the different mods. Hopefully that helps with a rough estimate of the price. But yeah, some of you guys have been asking about the mods. So I thought we would just kind of walk through all the mods on my Lowrider. So hopefully this helps. What's up, guys? So as I'm walking through these mods, I've listed, like I said in the description, all the names and the prices. That way it kind of helps out. But I've tried to find a balance of the mods between aesthetics and then also the function. So starting off in the front here, this is the Clockworks 8-inch flare windshield. So I was getting some a lot of clean wind from the stock windshield, which isn't that bad, it's better than buffeting. But for longer trips, it kind of started to wear on me just a lot after a couple hours of riding, just have the constant wind hitting you in the face. So I tried to find a windshield that was bigger, but also thought it looked sick. And so I ordered the 10-inch and the 8-inch flare Clockworks windshield. 10-inch, I actually got more buffeting, which is weird. I don't really get how the wind, you know, comes off, but the 8-inch, I have zero buffeting. And so it's a perfect balance for me. I'm 5'10", of trying to find a windshield that doesn't have buffeting, there's no clean air hitting me now that I'm riding, super comfortable. Great for long trips, and I just think it looks cool. I think the flare kind of looks sick, so I just keep it on as my daily driver. So height on the Clockworks 8-inch flare windshield. I got the dark smoke too. I think it looks cool. The windshield was about $250. So the stock headlight's cool, but I wanted something brighter, and I also wanted something that looked cooler. I was debating between this, the MC, the Moon's MC FlyEye V2, and then the Baja. I ended up going with this just because I thought it looked cooler. It's super, super bright. And so having no problem with, you know, having people see me during the day or during the night. During the day, I'll just put my brights on and it's super bright. So I think it looks sick. It has the option for the turn signals if you want to hook them up. I didn't. I also have a tutorial on this, on the install on my channel if you were curious. Had to drill 3 holes, but it really wasn't bad. I'm no grease monkey, but it was easy for me to do, so it's not bad. And then the headlight here was about $270. Now with the turn signals, I ended up going with the Custom Dynamics LEDs, and they're $90. However, I personally am kind of upset with them. The fitment, it felt like it wasn't meant for the Lowrider ST. So it said on my website it was, but I kind of had to jimmy rig it, and a lot of times my right turn signal doesn't work. The light will turn on the LEDs, but when I actually hit the turn signals, it doesn't work. I eventually got it fixed, so I'm happy about that. But for the longest time, it wasn't really working well. Same with the rears. But it looks cool and it works now, so I'm happy. But it was kind of annoying. I felt like the fitment was off. Okay, so I had to get a different mod for the handlebars, right? The original stock, I was noticing I was having some shoulder pain from just being kind of hunched over. I wanted something a little bit taller, a little bit closer to me. So I ended up going with the FXR Division split angle 16-inch T-bars. Okay, so I got those, the band grips, and then I went with the Dakota Digital gauge, okay? Everything together with all the fitment parts, you know, I had to get extra cables or cable extenders, ended up being about $1,300. However, this is hands down my favorite mod. It feels perfect, it looks sick, it's way more comfortable, no shoulder pain. Before, I had the Thrashin risers, the 6.5-inch. They were sick, but I wanted more. So I was debating between going with the 9.5 risers or going with these guys. I'm glad I went with these guys. Way sick. And the Dakota Digital gauge is amazing. There's so many different like drop down things you can look at. It's pretty crazy. I'm still trying to figure it out. You can customize everything on it, like all the different colors and how it looks. And so that's super, super cool. I'm happy with it. Now I have the crash bar. This is the Harley Davidson flat out crash bar. And so this is kind of just a nice safety feature to have. It also acts as kind of a nice highway pegs. If I want to extend my legs or whatever on a ride, it's super easy to just freaking throw them up. Good position, it's comfortable, but yeah, I like the aesthetics of it. I think it looks tough, how it's the bars. Yeah, I think it was listed for $300 on those. Now, with the Lowrider ST, you have to get the Lowrider ST kit that comes with this. You can't just buy it as it is, because there's one extra part that it comes with for an adapter for the ST. So make sure if you're getting it on the website that you get the Lowrider ST kit with the crash bars. I went with the Quadlox charging mount for the front here. Runs for $70. I like Quadlox a lot, does a great job, no issues, doesn't vibrate, just easy, and then charges my phone as well. So hyped on that. Now, with the floorboards here, I went with the Thrashin mini floorboards. They, I think, sold for $380. It's kind of pricey, but they're really, really nice. They're super grippy. I think they look sick. I wish I would have gotten the normal size, not the minis. So I don't have a huge foot, right? I have size 10, but seeing how they look on Max, CBO, and then also on Max Road King, because these are normal ones, I wish I would have gotten bigger. These just kind of look small now. Still cool, still better than, you know, the stock, but just in hindsight, I'm like, okay, frick, I wish I would have gotten the bigger ones, but still sick. Now for the seats, this is a Salomon step up seat. I love Salomon. I had a Salomon on my Sportster before. And I don't know, it's comfy, it has the option for the passenger. I think it looks really tough. I wanted something that would kind of go along with the bronze rims. And on their website, you can kind of custom make them, but I found this one actually on eBay, private seller. I'll list it in the description, but it runs for $600. I've put probably a couple thousand miles on the seat. It's comfy. It takes about 500 miles for it to break in. But the look and the feel, I love the Salomon seat. And it kind of matches that kind of dark black and then that bronzy brown kind of tint that the bike has. So yeah, hyped on the seat, super stoked on that. And then for the exhaust, I do want to do a stage 2 eventually for my bike with the cam, the air filter, the exhaust. But for the meantime, I wanted the bike to sound mean. And as you guys know, the stock exhaust sounds like a sewing machine. And so I threw on the slip-ons. Okay, this is the Tap Performance Zombie slip-ons.
Let me fire up the bike that we can kind of get an idea about the exhaust.
Now for the back, the license plate, I just ordered off Amazon, it was like $30. A license plate lay down kit. You know, it is normally standing up the stock, so this kind of lays it down. I think it's a sick, kind of cleaner look. Other mods I want to do eventually, like I said, it'd be sick to have the bigger floorboards. The brake obviously would be sick as well to do a thrashing brake. I have the reverse crash bars I want to put on. But yeah, I'm overall super stoked on the ST. The mods fit me. I think they look sick and they're functional. So finding that balance I think is really important with the mods.
But yeah, guys, overall, super stoked on the mods. Let me know in the comments below what you guys think. I'm also curious, like I said, about doing stage two. So if you have advice on the exhaust, on the air filter, on the cams, let me know. I'm sure a lot of you guys have done more research on this than I have. It's kind of like a new thing for me. So yeah, super curious to know your thoughts. So comment below, and yeah, appreciate you guys. We have something crazy happening with the CVO. It's gonna be nuts. So stay tuned for next week's video. Big change is coming with the CVO. And we're gonna do some more content as well with the Road King, because the Road King's freaking sick. And we've been doing some cool mods to that. So yeah, appreciate you guys. Thanks a ton for all the love and support you guys give. Okay, ride safe, peace.